Christmas is the reason for the season. And we say that Christmas is not about presents, but try selling that to a 7-year-old. I mean, let's just be honest. Nothing can pollute the atmosphere of a Christmas morning like a really bad gift. I mean, you have this year, and then it's just a big letdown. I come from a long line of bad gift givers, so this has kind of become second nature. Christmas of 97, my aunt gave me a watch. Great gift. But when I thanked her for it, all she said was, oh. She explained to me that the watch was for Chris on the other side of the family. When I was 16 years old, my mom gave me a floor lamp. A floor lamp. Like what 16-year-old boy is walking into his
Christmas Eve celebration. All family was going to descend on identify? Has the Advent season felt a little bit like that for you? Just rushing through, maybe you've missed the whole message. Over the last few weeks, we've been focusing on this idea of God being with us. And tonight is the night where it all comes to fruition. With God descending from heaven to earth, Emmanuel is what we call him, which means God is with us. The Christmas story, it's a powerful story. It's filled with wonder and miracles, but it's really real life too, isn't it? It's the story of Jesus leaving the glories of heaven to come to the earth, the most wonderful gift of all eternity. And as we've walked through this various parts of our Christmas story in these past few weeks, we've been exploring it at the intersection of real life people and God coming to earth. And we've seen how he's brought hope and love and joy and peace into the lives of these characters in the Bible. And he comes to do the same for us today. If I asked you if I could come over to your house to look in your garage or your shed or your attic tonight, I bet I would find some pretty unique stuff, wouldn't I? I bet if I looked at that place, I might find some stuff from Christmas's past that has ended up in one of those places at your house. If I took a little field trip to visit, I have a feeling you might pull out some things to show me. If you came over to my house, you might find this. You might find the Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer book. It belonged to my sister and I. It was a gift from our parents. Now, what you would notice if you looked at it really carefully, A, it's old, which means I'm old. And then you would notice that in the front, the page is kind of loose. And then you might notice how this one is a little bit torn. We just make up the words on that page. And then what you might notice as you get towards the back, that someone very lovingly added a little blue accent to Rudolph the marker. That would be you might wonder, why in the heck is she keeping this old ratty book? Like, you know, if I made new books that tell the same story. But you know why, right? You know why I keep the book with the torn pages and the blue marker in it? Because it reminds me of Christmas and my parents and my childhood. It means something. So in your garage, or your shed, or your attic, my guess is there are things like this. Things you've kept, held on to them because they're valuable to you. They can't be replaced. If I were to ask you about that certain unique item that you would find, you would take it out, and you probably would start telling me where you received it, or who gave it to you. If we went a little deeper, I'd hear about the relationship of the giver, wouldn't I? You might tell me things like, they were significant in my life, or he was a terrific person, or I loved her. And so this object, this thing, is more than just a thing, isn't it? This physical thing that you've kept stashed away in your garage or in your attic is actually about a relationship, isn't it? It's about a moment in time. It's about this person, this event, this circumstance, this battle, this struggle. This is what it's about. It may not appear initially, but that's what it's really about, isn't it? That's why you're keeping it. A few minutes ago, we heard the Christmas story. The story about a young couple, Mary and Joseph, going to Bethlehem to be counted in the census. This story about them being pregnant, and because the town was all full, there was no place for them to stay except the stable. This story about a baby being born to them, and the baby that they named Jesus, and the story about the shepherds coming, and the wise men coming, and the angels singing. It is a great story. This story we sing about. This story we tell our kids. remember, and we need to remind ourselves that this is what Jesus is all about. It is by the grace of God that salvation and life and hope and restoration have been revealed to us. It has appeared among us. God with us has come near to you and to me. And the question is, will you receive? There was a man in the Bible named Titus. He writes these words. For the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all people. This baby being born is about that. Bringing salvation and hope and renewal and restoration for all people. Christmas is about that. God's gracious gift given to all people. His salvation is revealed to us. Now, whether you realize it or not, that's what each one of us needs this Christmas. That's why Jesus came. That baby grew up to be a man who was all about restoring people to life. That baby grew up to be a man who would heal and help and forgive and listen and love and restore the broken. That baby born in the stable grew up to be the one in whom and through whom salvation would be found. That is what Christmas is about. Humanity's reception of this incredible gift. So the question becomes, what are you and I going to do with that? What are we going to do with a baby who came for us? Let's be honest. Some of us bring out the baby at Christmas time. We find him in the attic, we dust him off, and we put him up on the shelf, and Jesus makes his annual appearance. But we quickly put him back in the closet by New Year's Eve. Because we don't really want Jesus looking over our shoulder much. Now some of us have a cross on the wall, or a footprints poem, or that picture of Jesus hanging up in our house as a reminder, or a good luck charm, or something. We feel like we can't get rid of it. And still others among us have chosen to open ourselves up to the one who comes for us. Some choose to receive this gift that is offered to us, and we stand before him and we say, I'm in, Jesus. I am all in. And we realize that we didn't earn this gift, but it was a gift of God's grace. So how are you going to deal with this gift? How are you going to deal with this baby? You know, he's used to being relegated to the garage, or the attic, or the stable. I mean, after all, that's where he was born. He's used to seeing the no vacancy sign hanging on our busy lives. But deep down, you and I both know, we can't get rid of it. We gotta hold on to him, that there's something more to this child. And at Christmas, tonight, this evening, each of us comes to acknowledge that this night and these days ahead of us are what it's all about. That we need this one in our lives to be our hope and our salvation. We need to see him and this journey that we're on. And this is what Christmas is all about. Now, in the days and the weeks that are going to follow Christmas, we're going to go about our lives. We're going to get really busy again. We're going to get hectic, and things are going to happen, and the difficulties are going to come, and the tragedies and the times are going to be challenging, and we're going to find ourselves adrift. And we're going to wish that we could find God with us. Because what could we use a fresh dose of hope and love and joy and peace? And I want to remind you of this night. Because Jesus is the fulfillment of all hope. And he's the embodiment of all love. And Jesus is the source of all joy. And Jesus is the peace that passes all understanding. And Jesus is life. If you really want to know what life is like, invite Jesus in. Because if you choose him, he will walk with you, and you will never walk alone again. In Romans chapter 5, Paul captures a snapshot of what this life in Christ looks like. so listen to this. Therefore, since we have been made right in God's sight by faith, we have peace and with God because of what Jesus Christ our Lord has done for us. Because of our faith, Christ has brought us into this place of undeserved privilege where we now stand. And we confidently and joyfully look forward to sharing God's glory. We can rejoice too when we run into problems and trials, for we know that they help us develop endurance. And endurance develops strength of character, and character strengthens our confident hope of salvation. And this hope will not lead to disappointment, for we know how dearly God loves us, because he has given us the Holy Spirit to fill our hearts with his love. Did you hear it? Hope, love, joy, peace. All right there in Romans chapter 5. It's a life in Christ promise to us. It's a beautiful description of what it looks like to let Jesus rule in your heart this day. So tonight, on the eve of Christmas, let's be like the shepherds. They eagerly go to see Jesus, and they worship him. And then what do? They go back out, glorifying and praising God for everything they have seen and known and experienced, because it is all that God has promised. Let's go like the shepherds, rejoicing and praising and thanking God for this incredible gift. This undeserved gift. This gift we too often take for granted. A gift that looks a lot like a jeans and fruit quilt to an 8-year-old. Let us remember what an incredible gift we've been given this Christmas. Let's pray again. God, we thank you for this beautiful gift, this incredible reminder of your holy presence with us. We thank you, God, that tonight we can receive again the gift. Help us do that, Lord.